Hello, Pottery Pals. Welcome and long time no see. This is the Pottery Pod for February 6th, Sunday, 2011. I'd like to welcome each and everyone back to the Pottery Pod. We've got a new host for our podcast and better video and audio, and so I've got lots of ideas. And let's start those ideas today with throwing small bottles off the hump. So what I've got here is about 3 pounds of clay, and that's probably way too much for this particular exercise, so just go ahead and center it, and I'm going to go old school and cone this 3 pounds of clay up just so that I can get it a little bit more homogenized, and it tends to want to stay more centered when you cone it up. And after we've centered it, I'm going to go ahead and check it, and then I'm just going to use the edge of both my hands and pull it straight up into a pointed cone. So once you get your pointed cone, don't look at the cat, once you get your pointed cone done, I'm going to go ahead and just balance out the top and make a little area to work with right there, just like centering normally. And take the finger and pierce the inside of it about an inch down. And the problem with throwing off the hump is you're going to get a problem with S-cracks. I'm going to go ahead and just take that little roll of clay that was left and just balance with the inside of my finger on the inside and take a knuckle. Just do a standard knuckle pull, but I'm running the wheel really, really fast. And if you notice, you don't have to press on it as hard, press on the clay or grab the clay as much as when the wheel's spinning so fast. I'm going to go ahead and just work on the lip a little bit here. And I'm going to go ahead and take a few more little knuckle pulls. Now you'll notice I'm actually quite a bit lower than how far I pierced the inside of it, and there's a reason for that. And we'll go ahead and get a little cylinder made, go ahead and tighten up the top just like normal, and you can pretty much do anything you want. Now I'm going to go ahead and put my finger in a little bit further, and I'm going to go ahead and belly the bottom of this little form out just a little bit with my knuckle. And now's about the time it's going to start getting thin enough, because the clay's really, really thin, wet, I should say, and it's going to start wanting to wobble a little bit. So after I go ahead and center it up again with just a little bit of a belly on there, now's the time to get your old trusty tools out here. So I'm just going to use your atypical rib here, and I'm actually going to pierce down a little bit into the hump so that I can define the foot or the base of this pot quite well. So with that base defined, I mean, you can go way in, but you've actually got like a really thin piece of clay that's spinning really fast, and even though I've slowed the wheel down quite a bit, it's still going faster than you'd normally run something. I'm going to go ahead and just keep bellying it out a little bit and really define that shape with my finger supporting the inside of the little pot, and using that finger to push the form up against the edge of the wooden tool and start defining a shape. Now I'm really slowing down because it's getting, you know, thin enough to where, you know, at this speed, one mistake is catastrophic. The thing will just fly all over the place. So we've gone ahead and we've defined a little pot. I'm going to go ahead and collar in the top just a little bit, make it a little bit more bottle-like. Enough to still get a cork in there, a little bit of cork. Put some demarcations and features, lines here and there. And another thing about throwing minis off the hump or small objects off the hump, you're going to get so much slip on the piece that sometimes it's going to be hard to tell what it even is. So pulling that excess slip off is always a good idea. I'm going to go ahead and put a concave little neck so it helps it. I'm also scraping off quite a bit of slip by doing that and defining that little rim, that little glazed catch up there just a little bit more. And that's pretty much it. The clay is really groggy that I'm using, so I'm going to go ahead and take a chamois, if I can find it. Here's a chamois, and just soak it in water. These things are great. I suggest you go buy yourself a chamois and cut it into small strips and use it in your studio if you don't. They're a wonderful tool. You take this wet piece of leather chamois, and you just lay it over the rim while it's moving, and just let it lightly brush it, and it polishes things up really nice, and it makes for an excellent finishing edge. So voila, finished little bottle. And you can throw quite a few off the hump. I imagine you could probably get 10 to 15 off this little hump, just for what it's worth. And it's about 2.5 inches or so. I'm going to go ahead and take my wire tool, and just kind of cut in to the bottom. I'll go ahead and trim these out by hand a little bit later, so it doesn't really matter what the bottom looks like. Pull that off, and there you have it. Thanks for watching the Pottery Pod, and we'll be back as soon as possible.